So you played, you know, drums, you mentioned, but do you play other instruments as well?
I play around with other instruments as well.
You play around them? You mean like you sing yes. while other people play?
Yes, exactly. Essentially, yes.
So what do you dabble in?
I love playing guitar. It's kind of one of those deals out of the earlier tirade about always being in a position to where you had to wait on other guys to come in and play to write stuff. And it just became a necessity that if I'm going to write songs, I have to be able to have... I've had a guitar around the house since, I don't know, I was probably... My cousin Mark traded me a... My grandfather bought... this old Telecaster copy. It was like, I don't know, a $60 guitar.
Yeah.
Made by Pan. It wasn't a bad company. The wood was good. The neck was good. The pickups were okay. And my cousin Mark had made this BC Rich, before BC Rich, he had made this kind of body. You remember back in the day in the old, like Hit Parader and stuff like that, BC Rich ran an ad one time that said, you know, help us design... a guitar, you know, help us, though, send us your designs kind of thing.
Yeah.
And it is uncanny, and I wish I had that guitar. I don't know what the hell I did with it. But my cousin Mark, like, got that out. He was my cool dude in my family, you know. He was he was a guy with the long hair. He was playing guitar, and I was, you know, the same way he was for you, as that John was for you growing up. He was the guy that was like getting all the cool stuff and, you know, playing music and smoking pot.
Get out of here, Dewey.
What are y'all doing in here?
We're smoking reefer, and you don't want no part of this shit.
You're smoking reefers?
Yeah, of course we are. Can't you smell it?
No, Sam. I can't.
Come on, Dewey. Join the party.
No, Dewey. You don't want this. Get out of here.
You know what? I don't want no hangover. I can't get no hangover.
It doesn't give you a hangover.
What? I get addicted to it or something?
It's not habit forming.
Okay, well, I don't know. I don't want to overdose on it.
You can't OD on it.
It's not going to make me want to have sex, is it?
It makes sex even better.
Sounds kind of expensive.
It's the cheapest drug there is. You don't want it.
I think I kind of want it.
Okay, but just this once. Come on in.
And all of that kind of stuff, all the things that you think about when you're a young rock and roll dude, it's like, fuck yeah, one day I'm going to smoke some pot, and I'm going to learn how to play guitar, you know. But he got this band.
In that order.
He actually filled out a deal and sent it in to and entered that BC Rich contest, and it never heard anything back or anything like that. But it, I swear to you, is it the Warlock or is it the Bitch? Not the Warlock's the one with the diamonds, right?
Yeah.
Which
was badass.
It was the other, not the Mockingbird. Anyway, it was one of those that was eerily close to what my cousin Mark had actually built. It was really.
They probably stole it and just to give you credit. Like, there's no
BC Rich Bitch.
No, because that was, it may have been, it was the Bitch.
It has a little curves out on that,
I thought that was the Mockingbird. The one that Lita Ford plays. Lita Ford plays the one that's got that little jut out and then comes around the side.
See, I thought Lita Ford played the Warlock. So none of us know what.
No, absolutely.
Like, well, we Lita know Ford they exist.
Maybe she plays them all.
Oh, she did. She did.
Sorry, Lita.
I always wanted her to play with me.
I did too. She played with Ozzy.
If I close my eyes forever, will it all remain unchanged?
One of my favorite ballads of all time.
John had the costume. He was like, I had the warlock costume and everything, and she didn't play me one time.
Please, please.
Fuck you, Lita Ford.
Sending her mail.
Fucking tease.
But anyway, so the design, I just was saying, they probably were like, change this degree by 2 degrees, and then we'll take it for ourselves.
It was a really cool guitar. So that I had a guitar around all the time, having to play, having to finally come to the point where I was like, dude, if I'm either gonna sit here at the house and do nothing. I mean, I can play you a funky little beat, but it ain't gonna mean shit.
Yeah.
You know? And I know a lot of guys that just sit down and write lyrics and just write and just write. I'm not like that. I've never been that way. I've never just like written words.
Me. That's what I just sit around writing.
Writing words.
That's what I do too.
If I did it, I think it would come out a lot more contrived than the way that it has for me. That's not it. Every writer has a different element of what they do that actually, it's the way that they relate to the task at hand. I'm the more the guy that looks for, I like song titles. You know, I like something in a song title that you just kind of go, you know what? I know what the payoff should be. Let's see if you can get
deliver.
It there.
You know? Dude, I am exactly with you on that. I would just write titles, just come up with titles, because if you had that, then you could build a story around it.
It absolutely.
And it's kind of a lost art, to be honest. You
it
know,
is.
There for a while, it just got to be where, like, well, this song's called, you know, your daddy's a dick. You
right.
know,
and it was a song
no
about
art
your,
to
it
or anything.
Right.
Yeah, you wouldn't really
now,
relate.
There is something on the flip side of that. And I think maybe as I get older, I think the flip side of that very thing, which I like doing, because that's creative writing.
Yeah.
You're writing to suit a particular story or tell a story and be creative in what story you're going to tell to go with that. But I think there also is a place where you see guys, writers open up for the first time where they actually had to dig way deep and come out with some shit that was about them, that they lived, that they weren't just had telling a story that they heard somewhere that affected them very deeply. They were actually telling something that they lived. And there's a lot of newer artists. Have been around. I mean, you know, you guys know how it is. When you're doing music, man, you can be in the scene, you can be doing shit for 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 years and not get your break until you move away from maybe who you were playing with in the first place and join another particular group of guys, and that chemistry kind of sets it out.
Dude, I mean, you laid it out perfectly, because that was my aha moment, because I grew up wanting to, like, tell, you know, the whole going back to the putting on the show for the songwriting process, I wanted to tell a story, you know, have it be complicated and like a plot, you know,
and cool,
you know, like Queen's like Operation Mindcrime. That was, you know, I fucking rewrote lyrics to that whole album, just my own lyrics to
right.
it. But because I wanted to tell a story like they did, and it took me fucking years, probably not until I was like 25 years old to really click.
Make that connection.
And I wrote a song that was just coming from me, and I was like, whoa. Mama, take my hand and get me just a little bit. That was already 10 times better than anything I've ever written in my life.
It opens you up to be able to be accessible to your audience and
relatable to your audience.
100%, because it's all about relating to the people. You really and truly, you're kind of, a lot of us do music to release something.
Yes.
That maybe we've just had inside. We use it as a release and various ways, whether it's releasing, venting anger, or whether it's expressing extreme joy, or
closure, or
sure, yeah. Absolutely, and that makes sure that really makes your opportunities limitless for what, and then you realize that's the basic common denominator between all people, or the stuff that people write about, and you know, you get a sense of being able to say what you think on something, and hopefully people relate to it. And maybe somebody goes, you know, I listened to your song, dude. It really made me feel better.
But even beyond that,
and you're like, you're totally weird, because it didn't make me fucking feel better. But I'm glad I did something for you. So here, buy my CD. Yeah.
But even beyond that, it's a genuine, it's a more genuine, product.
Yeah, absolutely.
Than necessarily emulating what's cool or.
And nobody's going to connect with that.
Yeah. So,
I mean, from an artistic standpoint, from genuine art, like it's like hotel art that's like just made to be hotel art.
Like generic.
Right? And then there's art that somebody just wanted to create some shit and then somebody happened to want to buy it.
Yep, absolutely.
Palpa Bond Drilling, where are you? Dean Trophy Suite 100 and doodly doo. Sherman Blinds and Rugs, Suite 202.
Here it is.
Palpa Bond Drilling.
Suite 401.
Yeah, I was going to sing that part.
I know, now you don't have to.
Yeah. Except it was going to resolve the melody, so now my head hurts. Feels like I held in a sneeze. I hate this feeling. Sweet 401.
So let's talk about resolving the melody. This conversation on what makes art great and the process of catharsis really got me thinking on the idea from author Elizabeth Gilbert that all great art should have two main qualities: to be surprising and inevitable. And I feel like some of the best times of catharsis come from those moments that shock you back into the present on a hyper-realistic level. Those aha moments, if you will, they surprise you and shake you to your core, but allow your mind to then, once again, settle into consensus. Like a good melody, the best things in life, including art, should surprise, then resolve. The inevitable. Philosopher Jason Silva talks about this idea here.
And that's the power of an original work, of something that has great resonance, of something that gets under your skin, of something that gives you the goosebumps, of something that gives you a skin orgasm when the hairs on the back of your neck stands up. That's what great art, great films, great literature, great paintings, that's what great music does, right? What's that quote that says music is proof the human race is greater than it knows? Well, the best songs do that too. The best songs surprise. Right? They confuse you and confound you in that you don't know exactly what the next note is going to be, and so you track it. But then it's perfectly harmonious, and it works for you, and it's sticky, and it gets under your skin, and you have an emotional reaction, and you're like, of course, that's the most beautiful song I've ever heard. Why didn't somebody else think of that before? See, that's what great art is.
Yeah. And you know, it's a totally different thing. People know when you're just being genuine, and they feel that sense of authenticity from whatever the songwriter is doing. And when somebody's like, no, you didn't. You didn't live that life. You didn't do that shit.
I'm a cowboy on a steel horse I ride. I want it, hell of a life. Want it, hell of a life.
I'm not on a steel horse you ride, motherfucker. That ain't what we're talking about.
And also, not just that, but they...
fucking cowboy.
By the way, actually, he did. Richie Sambora was that steel horse.
We'll do some lines off fucking Richie's back. There you go.
You know it happened, dude.
Richie was living on a prayer. And actually, I like Richie. I really can't stand John Bon Jovi.
Yeah, I mean, he's the one. Well, I love John Bon Jovi, but Richie was the one that was driving a lot of that stuff.
Absolutely.
It was kind of like wrangling cats, I feel like. Like, John Bon Jovi had all these ideas, but Richie was like, okay, but let's focus on
this. But you can't play guitar, so you're one of those guys. you got to have that. You play guitar by having guys around you play guitar.
Listen to me go,
yeah. But once, you know, John broke free of that and was like, I know four chords, by God, and I will write my own shit. Bye, Mr. Sambora. Thank you.
Do you see this face? You can't create this face, motherfucker.
Bitch, I'm Bon Jovi. I don't even know who you are. You the guitar player. I'm Bon Jovi. The band name ain't Sambora or Richie.